The Royal Australian Air Force was the first in the world to adopt the concept of the collaborative combat aircraft and announced the MQ-28A Ghost Bat program at the Avalon Air Show in 2019. Since then, the Royal Air Force, US Air Force and US Navy have also invested heavily in AI-enabled, uncrewed and autonomous reconnaissance, surveillance and tanker aircraft. What they all do in common is force protection. The RAAF have announced their operational StormShroud uncrewed aerial system based on the Anglo-Portuguese Takeva AR-3. This autonomous collaborative aircraft uses a Leonardo UK Brightstorm electromagnetic warfare system to blind or disrupt enemy air defence radars. It is 1.9 metres long, with a 3.5 metre wingspan, a cruising speed of about 90 kilometres per hour and no weapons. Its payload is just 4 kilograms, most of which is taken up by the 2.5 kilogram Brightstorm. StormShroud is to support RAF Typhoon and F-35B Lightning II fighters attacking unseen targets. The Brightstorm AJ-band electronic warfare system, launched in 2024, is built on Leonardo, UK's proven and highly regarded digital radio frequency memory technology, and can either jam or spoof enemy radars. In concept, it's not that different from the EA-18G Growler used by the US Navy and RAAF, but its small size imposes certain limitations. The Growler is based on the two-seat Super Hornet, but carries a range of radar and communications jammers and weapons to blind or shut down hostile emitters and protect itself. The sheer size of the Growler and its twin engines enable system performance and sophistication that's denied to smaller platforms. The Growler's electronic warfare suite consists of wideband receivers in the wingtips, high and low band tactical jamming pods, an advanced targeting forward-looking infrared pod, and a communications countermeasures system. The tactical jamming pods will be replaced shortly in RAAF service by next-generation jammers, which were used in anger by the US Navy over the Red Sea in 2024. The Growler can also carry the AIM-120 AMRAAM and AIM-9X Sidewinder for air-to-air engagements, and the AGM-88 high-speed anti-radiation missile and AGM-88E advanced anti-radiation guided missile, though not all at once, obviously. The StormShroud embodies an important lesson from Ukraine. Build lots of small, affordable UASs because their attrition rate is expected to be significant. The Growler, by contrast, is a big, very capable and rather expensive beast, designed to escort strike aircraft and suppress enemy air defences and communications. It is also designed to return its two-person crew safely back home. More attritable are the Boeing Defence Australia MQ-28A Ghost Bat and the US-made Anduril Industries YFQ-44A Fury and General Atomics Aeronautical Systems YFQ-42A. All three are autonomous UASs and are designed to escort or go ahead of crewed air defense, strike or surveillance aircraft, suppress enemy air defenses, ground or airborne, and do the dangerous surveillance and suppression of enemy air defenses, work currently done by crewed aircraft. Intended to be an order of magnitude cheaper than crewed aircraft, the exact cost of each hasn't been disclosed. The Ghost Bat made its first flight in 2021 and made its 100th flight in April this year, according to Jared Hayes, chief engineer of Boeing's Phantom Works. It is 11.7 meters long with a 7.3 meter wingspan and a 2,000 nautical mile or 3,700 kilometer range. Although its engine type hasn't been disclosed, it flies at fighter-like high subsonic speeds and is designed to be agile. It allows rapid insertion and testing of third-party autonomy, says Hayes, and has rapidly changeable nose cones carrying different payloads so it can fly different intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance and electronic warfare missions. The RAAF doesn't plan to arm the Ghost Bat initially, but will watch closely Boeing's planned trial with air-to-air missiles later this year and could adopt an armed version in due course. All its service trials this year are intended to result in advice to the government from the RAAF early next year, with a possible service entry in 2028. To keep its costs down, the Ghost Bat depends for stealth on its shape, rather than radar-absorbent materials, and its one-piece composite wing is made using resin infusion technology developed by Boeing Australia at Fisherman's Bend for composite wing trailing edge components on the Boeing 777 airliner. The Ghost Bat taxis, takes off and lands under ground control. In flight, it comes under the command of a crewed aircraft, a Wedgetail, Super Hornet or F-35A. The essential human in the loop is a mission execution custodian who could be aboard a crewed aircraft, if there's room, or in the ground control station used for takeoffs and landings. In June 2025, Australian Defence revealed that one of its Wedgetails had flown with two Ghost Bats and a single mission execution custodian in the system's first airborne trial of manned-unmanned teaming. A few days later, it disclosed that a single Ghost Bat had flown from RAAF base Tyndall in the Northern Territory. In the US, General Atomics YFQ-42A and Anduril's YFQ-44A Fury are designed to support both fifth-generation aircraft such as the F-35 and F-22, and the USAF's new sixth-generation Boeing F-47 next-generation air dominance fighter. These aircraft are designed to carry sensors and air-to-air weapons, with the YFQ-44A carrying two AIM-120 AMRAAM missiles externally, while the YFQ-42A will carry them internally. General Atomics had pioneered weapons integration with their MQ-1 Predator and MQ-9A Reaper, using the AIM-9X Sidewinder and MQ-20 Avenger, which carries a variety of weapons internally. Both YFQ aircraft are considerably smaller than Ghost Bat, at about 6.1 meters long for the Fury with a 5.2 meter wingspan. A single Williams F-44 turbofan gives the Fury a maximum speed of Mach 0.95 and airframe stressing of plus 9G and minus 3G suggests fighter-like maneuverability. Performance figures and dimensions haven't been disclosed for the YFQ-42A, but they are believed to be about the same. The YFQ-42A is part of General Atomics' four-platform Gambit series of uncrewed aircraft systems, which includes a sensing platform, a shooting platform, a training platform, and a low observable platform, all built from a common Gambit core chassis. The common core is about 70% of the aircraft, which enables General Atomics to manufacture at scale. The USAF will trial both aircraft extensively this year. The Ghost Bat wasn't offered as part of the USAF's trial program, but the US Navy has its own sixth generation next generation air dominance program, the FAXX, which will also reportedly use a collaborative combat aircraft. As both RAAF and US Navy pilots have been trained to operate the Ghost Bat, this gives rise to speculation that the Ghost Bat could equip US Navy and Marine fighter squadrons operating aircraft such as the Super Hornet and Lightning II, as well as the new FAXX. If a carrier variant of the Ghost Bat does equip the US Navy and Marines, it will operate alongside Boeing's MQ-25A Stingray tanker. This is the world's first autonomous carrier-based aircraft and should eventually replace the crewed Super Hornet as an aerial refueler. The Stingray carries 15,000 pounds of transferable fuel, and the US Navy's intent is that it should refuel 4 to 6 Super Hornets at a range of about 500 nautical miles, 930 kilometers. The aircraft is equipped with a single Cobham probe and Drogue aerial refueling store under its port wing. Powered by a single Rolls-Royce AE3007 turbofan engine with 10,000 pounds thrust, it is 15.5 meters long and has a wingspan of 22.9 meters. It is reported, though not confirmed, that it also carries an electro-optical infrared sensor ball in the nose and can carry AGM-158C long-range anti-ship missiles externally on the two wing hardpoints. The Stingray first flew in 2019, with its first aerial refueling and first carrier flight deck integration trials in 2021. The type is due to enter service in 2026, and the US Navy has ordered 76 of them to the tune of about $1.3 billion. As for the Royal Australian Air Force, it already operates the Growler, is likely to operate the Ghost Bat, and could also acquire one of the USAF collaborative combat aircraft, as well as the Stingray refueler. So, autonomous aircraft of all sizes are here to stay. In doing the increasingly dangerous work previously done by crewed aircraft, they add combat mass, sensor, and weapons range, and survivability in contested battle spaces. Thanks for watching. And if you appreciate what we are doing, please subscribe and support us by checking out our merchandise shop.